Hello, everybody. Scott Golden here with the Golden Opportunities Coaching YouTube channel and the Pro Wrestling Logic YouTube channel. This is the AEW Rampage event for the 22nd of April 2022. Adam Cole defeating Tomohiro Ishii with Rocky Romero and Orange Cassidy in an Owen Cup qualifier. Limit of 14 seconds. Not that impressed with Ishii comparatively, but anyway. Shoulder tackle early, sends Cole to the out of the ring. Cole hits a dive on the corner, and then they trade kicks. Ishii drops his opponent with a chop. They fight on the floor. Cole ducks a clothesline, coming back with some shots into the post instead. Cole sends Ishii into the barricades, tossing him back into the ring, and hit a little bit of ground and pound offense. Cole then drives a knee into Ishii's back and works chin lock for a while. Ishii no-sells a series of forearms from Cole, dropping Cole with a single forearm, catching Cole with a spinning power slam. Ishii hits a backdrop suplex and near fall. Cole then hits the Oshambo, and then we go to a split screen break. Back from the break, Ishii hits a delayed superplex. In near fall, Cole then dodges a sliding lariat and a super kick. Cole then goes to lower the boom, but then Ishii ducks and hits the sliding lariat for near fall. Ishii goes for brainbuster. Cole counters it with a kneecap brainbuster for a near fall. Cole then goes for the Panama Sunrise. Ishii avoids that and hits an enziguri for his trouble. Then both guys are down. Ishii makes it to his feet first. Ishii hits a headbutt. Cole comes back with a super kick. Ishii nails Cole with a lariat. Jay White runs down and then attacks Rocky Romero, throwing him into the ringside stairs. Distraction allows Cole to hit Ishii with a low blow, and Cole lowers the boom, getting the pin. Then we go earlier today. The AEW security sends the Jericho Appreciation Society out of the building, except for Danny Garcia, who has a match with Eddie Kingston later. Jericho is also filing a complaint with HR over this. Garcia promises to win because he's a sports entertainer. Hook speaks. Danhausen destroys a bag of chips in the back because they are the source of Hook's power. And you want my attention, you got it, says Danhausen. Anyway, Lance Archer defeats Serpentico, and Lance Archer comes with Jake Roberts in 33 seconds. Serpentico tries a tope before the bell. Suplex and everybody dies finishes Serpentico in short order. After the match, Archer chokeslams Serpentico. Spears on commentary is super exhausted by Archer chances against his opponent next week. And then we go to Eddie Kingston defeating Danny Garcia. 11 minutes 22 seconds of this air. And anyway, I'm not necessarily a fan of this, but I'm not as big a fan of Garcia as most other people are. Anyway, everyone from the respective groups makes their way out. Kingston brawls with Garcia and takes the fight to the floor, sending his opponent into the stairs and the barricade along the way. Kingston then misses a charge, colliding with the stairs. Garcia takes control. Garcia sends knees into Kingston's ribs, and then Kingston comes back with a chop, but Garcia hits a shoulder into the ribs. Garcia then keeps the work on the ribs going. Garcia works over Kingston in the corner, hits forearms, and Kingston comes back biting Garcia's ear. They fight to the floor again, and Garcia sends Kingston into the ring post. After the pitcher-in-pitcher break, both guys exchange strikes in the middle of the ring. Kingston then goes for a suplex, but Garcia counters into an abdominal stretch. Kingston then tries to counter, but Garcia turns into a German suplex for a near fall. Garcia then stomps on Kingston in the corner. Garcia then charges the boot, and Kingston follows up with the knee into the middle rope. Kingston then goes for DDT, but Garcia takes him down with a double leg takedown, sending him in with the Boston Crab. Kingston also makes it to the ropes. Garcia pulls him back into the sharpshooter. Kingston breaks the hold by getting to the ropes again. And then we go to Garcia going for another sharpshooter. Kingston gets out, catches Garcia with an enziguri half and half suplex. Kingston gets a near fall, and Garcia avoids a spinning back fist. Kingston catches him with a backdrop suplex, then hits the spinning back fist on the second try for the pinfall, and ultimately, not too terribly bad. After the match, Kingston threatens whipping Garcia with the belt, but gets on the microphone and tells Garcia to spare him. But they ultimately, Tony Schiavone interviews Keith Lee and Strickland. They promise war against Team Taz, and that things are between those two aren't over yet. Lee is disappointed that Taz interfered. Ricky Starks is offered a retort on commentary. Feud continues. Tony Schiavone also interviews Tony Storm, Dreamy Hayner, and Dr. Baker DMD. Storm took over the promo and promised to win the tournament. And then promo for Dynamite with Dax Harwood and Cash Wheeler, both promising to honor Owen Hart by winning the tournament. The rest of the Dynamite rundown didn't add any new matches to the show. Anyway, so then we go to the main event. We go to Jade Cargill with Mark Sterling, and the baddies at ringside defeats Marina Shafir to retain the TBS championship. Shafir starts with a bunch of leg kicks. That stuns Cargill. Cargill soon gets the advantage. Follow a slam clothesline on the floor. Cargill is dominant, and Sterling distracts the ref. Red Velvet and Kira Hogan beat on Shafir from behind the barricade. Back in the ring, Cargill gets a near fall after a back suplex. Cargill grind and pound offense, but position for Cargill allows Shafir to pick Cargill's leg and lock on a guillotine choke. Cargill then powers out and got another near fall. Show goes to its final split screen. Cargill then has an inverted abdominal stretch on Shafir, but escapes with a hip throw. Shafir then goes for Cargill's knee and locked on a knee bar. Cargill then got to the ropes to force a break. Shafir then wraps Cargill around the post and tosses Sterling on the floor. Then the baddies distracted Shafir, throwing popcorn at her. Cargill then blindsides her with a pump kick. Cargill then chokeslams Shafir onto the timekeeper's table and did not break. Anyway, so Cargill dumps Shafir back into the ring and then celebrates with the baddies at ringside. Cargill goes for an arrogant cover. Shafir wants nothing to do with this, and Cargill kicked her way out of the hold. Free leg, and then finishes Shafir off with the jaded slam. Anyway, post-match, money shot out of the ring post and green balloons from the ceiling to celebrate Cargill's victory. I don't know, kind of a flat nationwide show, but it is what it is, and this is wrestling in the 2022s. Anyway, we'll be back with more right after this.